Well, so even Darryl Dawkins, the league was forced to look for breakaway rims or figured out how to make breakaway rims because at those during the 70s, 60s, there were no breakaway rims. And Darryl Dawkins just really pulled those rings out of the board. Kaya nababasag yung mga board at that time. So these are things that you could say these are literal game changers. And because of the lack of standards, are they considered as the GOAT? And I think my third point to why the GOAT argument is wrong, is flawed, because basketball, and listen to this, people, everyone listen to this. Hey, what's up, buddy? Listen to this. My third point, and I hope everyone agrees with this, because if you don't, I think that's what's wrong with our world today. Basketball is still and will forever be a team sport. For you to recognize a GOAT, the greatest of all time, you're negating a lot of things. You're negating that basketball is a team sport. Four other guys mean nothing because there's one greatest player? I don't think so. And for you to call someone the GOAT, that means he's the greatest. He's above and beyond the sport itself. I don't think there was one player who defeated five players all by himself. May that be Jordan, LeBron, Wilt, Shaq, Kobe, you name it. I don't think that he could have even scored even just 10 points in his career if it weren't for a teammate who got the rebound, made that pass, gave that screen, hustled for that ball to be alive, to give it to someone, to the GOAT, to make his basket. And I hope you agree with me on that, because if you don't, it's going to be a big problem, because basketball is played 5-on-5. And we got the 3x3, that's 3-on-3. Unless we play 1-on-1, but I think you know what I mean. Okay, what's up? Oh, Tito Chops! Oh, I think you're still in Hong Kong. Chops, F1 forever. Mga nanana big boys, RJ, how are you, John? Congrats. Wilson, PCU Dolphin Days. And Coach Paolo, Coach Joed. I hope you're having fun with the topic, and I hope I'm not running too fast with this. Coach Joseph, congrats on your very excellent show. And to the others, in a while, I'll get back to you. Marky Mark, what's up? Pipo, Coach Pipo. I hope you're going to enjoy John Manalang with you sa team mo. And the rest, in a way, Lennon. Coach Lennon from the US of A. There is no GOAT without the four players on the court. Precisely my point. Thank you. Thank you, Coach ka talaga, Lennon. You see, four guys need to support even the best player on their team. But that best player wouldn't be anyone if not for the contributions of those four players. My case in point, Iverson. Then you put a lot of average NBA players plus Larry Brown. Then Allen Iverson propels the Sixers to the finals against the Giants, which were the LA Lakers. But it wasn't just Allen Iverson. It was Tyrone Hill. It was even Dikembe Mutombo, Aaron McKee, George Lynch, Eric Snow, Matt Geiger, for all people, I think he was still there. And the coaching of Larry Brown. It takes a lot of people to propel a basketball team to prominence. Maybe there's a one standout looking player, or maybe scores the most, but I'm going to get to that point in a while. Another case in point, again, I'm going to hear some flack over this. LeBron and the Miami Heat. It wasn't just LeBron. It was Wade, Bosch, and even Ray Allen. And then the coaching genius of Eric Spoelstra, which, by the way, is half Pinoy. Okay. Harold Gigante of the Porak Ballers. Abutit nakapanood ka rito. So, going back, LeBron would not have had a championship in Miami without those four guys: Spoelstra, Wade, Bosch, Allen, Mario Chalmers, Mike Miller, you name it, they were there. They're part of the team. They deserve, everybody on that team deserved to be a champion because they were. But also, not taking anything from LeBron, Wade, Bosch, and Allen would not have been champions if it weren't for LeBron as well. But where do we put the best, the greatest in that team? Who do we pinpoint to be the greatest? We have LeBron when he brought the Cleveland Cavaliers. A very I actually cried when tears fell when LeBron brought the Cleveland Cavaliers to their first ever championship in so many years. That was epic. That was for the history books. And LeBron with Kyrie Kevin Love and their coach Tyronn Lue. But I want to include their coach David Blatt, because it was David Blatt who prepped the other players around LeBron, Kyrie, and Kevin Love. If it weren't for David Blatt, I think those other guys, the crew, the Cavs crew, I think would not have gelled as well and would have not played as well together with LeBron, Kyrie, and Kevin Love. So they carried LeBron as well as LeBron carried that team. Tim Duncan, Greg Popovich, Parker, Ginobili. Then we have another era of Spurs basketball: Duncan Popovich, Sean Elliott, Avery Johnson, and the Admiral David Robinson. And sa Lakers, we have Shaq with that three-peat. But they had Kobe. They had Phil Jackson. They had the triangle offense. And before we even finish with that, if you talk about Phil Jackson, you always talk about the triangle offense. But when you talk about the triangle offense, it's Tex Winters, their assistant coach, who passed away a few years ago. But it was Tex Winters' system that made Phil Jackson believe that basketball is going to be played together with superstars being maximized. And that's what Jordan, Pippen, Rodman did in the Chicago Bulls era. And then Shaq, Kobe, Rick Fox, D-Fish. So it's going to be hard, really, to pinpoint the greatest, because everybody carried each other's back. And that's basketball. And it's not going to apologize, because basketball is a team sport. Will still is and will always be. So that's why I think the greatest of all time is a myth. Basketball is the greatest sport there is. That's what I believe in. But for someone to be more than the game or beyond the game, I can't agree to that. Basketball is such a great sport, such a beautiful sport, because it's being played together. For you to say that, oh, there's one who encompasses basketball at that era, at that time, and then you pit them against each other from different eras, it's going to be hard, really, to swallow. Coach Wang, hey, Gabby, yeah. Dami na, MJ still the GOAT. Yeah, whatever. I'm just saying, how can Jordan be the GOAT when he needed Pippen? Oh, no, but Jordan carried, na? Jordan still needed Pippen, still needed Steve Kerr, John Paxson, Horace Grant, Phil Jackson. Would you imagine Michael Jordan playing for another team, for another coach, with other teammates? Would he have achieved such epic proportions sa kanyang career if it weren't with Phil Jackson, the triangle offense, Tex Winters, Pippen? Diba parang ulam yan eh. It's just like food. You have to have the right ingredients to come up with a masterpiece. There was not one ingredient that was a masterpiece in itself. It took a lot of ingredients put together, cooked well, spiced up really well, perfectly, to have that winning recipe. And that's basketball for you. You might have a lot of onions to make it delicious, but it's not just the onions that made it delicious. But it took a lot, but it's not just the onions. And just like in basketball, it might take LeBron James a almost triple-double performance, but it still needed other players to make it a great recipe, a great game, a winning team. Tony Kukoc, oh, kita mo, di naglabasan na. 2018 finals win of the Cavs might put him in the GOAT. Yeah. I mean, a lion does not have to prove that he's a lion because he knows he is one. But going back to my point, it's a team sport. It's a team sport. Basketball is a team sport. So how can you gauge that someone in that team was the sole reason? Bill Russell, I think one player who really can boast about championship rings, but he needed a Bob Cousy, he needed a John Havlicek, he needed even a lucky shot from Don Nelson to win championships. It was not just Bill Russell. He inspired, he motivated his teammates to be propelled to higher heights. Yes, that's true, but it wasn't Bill Russell alone, and he even admits that he's just a part of a bigger team, of a bigger sum. And I think that's what basketball is, and that what makes basketball a very beautiful and great sport. I think I'm going to have some negative, violent comments from football lovers in a while. But, Joed, exacto to. Basketball is a team sport. I'll go to this later. But yeah, this is it. One of my points, really. So, before I go to my proposed solutions to this argument and maybe some of my conclusions, we'd love to hear from you. We'd love to hear your thoughts. Now, your thoughts on the show so far. Am I going too fast? Am I too excited talking right now? Am I shouting already? I don't know. All I'm feeling right now, I'm so pumped. I'm doing my first live episode. And I'll tell you, a lot of things really went wrong in the last minute. I'm not supposed to do this directly on Facebook Live. It was supposed to go through another another program going into Facebook Live. But strange things happen really when it's almost about to begin. And just had to adjust. And I'm just pumped up that I did. And for the people watching, thank you so much. But here's my point. And maybe a proposed solution. Maybe it's time that we really took care of this game. This game that we love, that we tell ourselves or we tell other people that the ball is life, that we love this game so much. Well, it's time, I think, to man up. I think it's time that we took care of this game by uplifting the traits in the game that truly matter. Yeah, we talk about not wanting to see players ball hog. And yet, we celebrate highlight reels of players scoring one-on-one situations. We never really celebrate passes. We never celebrate the hockey assist. We never celebrate those rebounds, except when Dennis Rodman came into town. But I think it's time that we ourselves really took an intentional step of taking care of this game. By uplifting the traits, making these things prominent,